ang Roland Dalo. Right now, we're here in the Senate building of, well, the Philippines, so we're obviously because we're in the Philippines. So, so, for today, we're going to interview Senator Teofisto Rincon III. Senator, good morning. Actually, good afternoon.
Call me PG.
At PG, sir. So, could you give us a brief background of who T.G. Rincon is?
Well, T.G. Rincon comes from Manila. Before he ran, he was a businessman. And he's a lawyer. And I would say fairly good looking.
Yes, actually, from whenever I watch him, he's like, Mr. Stay. Handsome man. So anyway, sir, about you being a lawyer, what's your, where's your alma mater, sir?
Well, Ateneo.
Ateneo, sir. Did you join any of the
fraternities? No. I want to take all the barbarians.
And then you're
those like, that don't join the tribes of barbarians.
So you're like the lone wolf, right? I don't need these groups.
Hindi naman, because you also have other barbarians. And I was friends with everyone, even the different
area. I see. So, sir, what made you run as a senator?
Well, you know, before that, I was a congressman.
Yes.
And we could see the corruption and the decay of institutions during my stint in Congress. Especially the decay of and the faith of the decay of institutions and the faith of citizens in our government, in our democratic processes. If you remember the Helo Garcia scandal,
I was really watching that.
That was the time when the COMELEC was not counting the votes, but was making the results of the elections. The military was used for the elections. General Gudali came out in a Senate committee report and on record said that the military was used to cheat votes.
To cheat, sir.
So, Comelec, military, you've got Karina DeVille was the chairman of the Civil Service Commission at that time. She went on record stating that 40% of all appointed government officials are not qualified for their post.
40%, sir.
40%, and they were appointed purely on the basis of political loyalty. So you've got, and I can go on and on and on. So you've got institution after institution after institution tainted with a scandal. Institutions where public have no more trust in them, and so it was time to rebuild the institutions to bring back faith to God.
I see. So, as a senator, how would you define what senators should be?
First, as a leader of the nation, you're looked up to. Second, you are a advocate. You should advocate, because you're a leader, you should advocate, push people in a certain direction that you believe will make the, which direction that you believe the nation will be benefited, the people will be benefited. And of course, third, lawmakers, the traditional role.
So, sir, for the third part, you said, lobby, a senator should be lawmaker. So, how do senators pass bills?
First, you file a bill. You draft your bill, you file it, then there are three readings. First reading is when it's read in the plenary, and then it's referred to the committee. Let's say your bill has something to do with human rights, then that's brought to the Committee of Justice. If it's something about corruption, then it's the maybe the blue ribbon, or if it's something to do with taxes, it's referred to the Committee on Ways and Means, depending on the committee, which jurisdiction and your subject matter. Then, in the committee level, there are hearings. Resource persons are called. And that's where you deliberate on the provisions of the bill. Then after that, it's brought back to plenary on second reading. The second reading, that's where the, all the senators debate on the merits and demerits of the provisions of the bill. They make amendments after the debates. And after the amendments, they are subjected to what we call the third reading. Third reading, ano na yan? Yun ang final, yes or no? Yes. Nanalong yes, magiging approved bill na yan. No? Pag nanalong no, wala yan.
Dadaan pa ba sa executive?
Hindi. Bago nun, kailangan yung Congress, yung House of Representatives, kailangan gumawa rin ng bill. Same procedure. Mm-hmm. So, ang paggawa ng batas, kailangan yung tinatawag na takes two to tango. Yung congressman sa House of Representatives at saka yung mga senator. Without a counterpart bill, hindi pwede. So, once may bill na yung approved bill na yung Senate, may approved bill na yung Congress, yun ang tinatawag na bicameral. Bakit by? BI. Kasi dalawa, Senate, Congress, Conference Committee. Doon, i-reconcile ngayon yung version ng Congress at saka yung version ng Senado sa bicameral. Pag naayos na yan, babalik na yung approved version ng bicameral, babalik muna sa Senate at sa House. Papa-approve yung final version. Pag na-approve ng both houses, babalik ngayon, pupunta na yan sa Malacanang kasi yun na yung bill. Once pinirmahan na set ng presidente, yun na yung batas.
Pero, kasi according to my research report, may power daw yung president na i-veto yung pinagpaluri ng bill.
At nangyari na.
Could you cite some examples?
Merong bill ng civil service na na-veto. Amending certain provisions of the civil service. Yung bill on giving terms to the chief of staff of the armed forces of the Philippines. Na-veto din. Yung early childhood education bill, na-veto din.
Ah, yes, I remember that. I was a preschool teacher. Okay, I heard about that. So, about bills, sir, have you ever passed a bill?
Yes.
How many?
Right now?
Yes.
We have passed, I would say fairly, roughly around 10.
10, so
yes.
Did any of them get to
become law?
Yes, sir.
I'm not. Aye. Anti-money laundering.
Ah, sir. No, that one. The one that was used by... Was that Ombudsman? Was that?
Yes.
Ombudsman...
Which, Tapio Morales.
Yes. Yeah, I remember that. So, sir, how do you work on that bill, sir?
Yo, that process that
you
I told
just,
you.
Yes, you process na ito. So, meron po kayong mga CV. Meron ba kayong personal details?
Well, as far as